Welcome to Crimson Guitars and welcome to this. I have been asked by many of you to do a river table guitar. I have listened. I think that edge, covered in gold leaf, bit of resin carved through, that's all going to look rather good, isn't it? See you now. We're going for a live edge here, where it's pretty. We're going for a live edge here, where it's pretty. And then basically a thin sliver from this side there. This is going to be pretty cool. We have got some amazing clear cast by Alumilite. This is from House of Resin. And this is nice thin stuff with which I am going to seal this. The last thing I want is bubbles. This is fun. I am going to use some of the Modern Finish grain enhancing filler. 1 to 2 hour curing gold side. And now the waiting begins. I've made this as close to the body blank size as possible because I don't want to waste resin because, you know, that would be a waste. And then I'm going to seal it with sealant and tape and all sorts of stuff because we don't want leaks. Ta-da! And here we go. I am incredibly happy with how this has turned out. Although we are not there yet. We are not there yet by a long shot. Oh, do you know what I need to do? Fool did not take the screws out. Hold on. Okay, bye. we have a thing. It's a thing, and it's full of thingness. It's so golden.
I have here an unfinished Crimson Guitars kit neck. I'm going to do something particularly cool.
Here we go. I think that's going to look stunning. Well, here we go. Yeah, that wasn't the easiest thing to cut through. Fairly thick.
Oh, that's pretty much cured. We need more resin in the back of that.
Plan is, I'm going to put some tape or something on the back here, and then I'm going to flood it with some resin, and we'll see what happens. The time has come.
Clear, beautiful, messy. Nope, nothing leaked through.
Nice. The end result is, well, it's getting there, isn't it? Let's get on with the fret. We are at the point of no return. Say hello to the point of no return. We have an outline. I think this is going to be fun. This is, without a doubt, one of the most useful tricks that we know of, and we use it all the time for holding things on CNC machines and router templates and things stock on my workbench. If you haven't tried this, go and check out the video, hopefully linked below, where I explain the whole thing again in a little bit more detail. It is amazing. That was a little bit messy, but pretty successful, really. Tiny router worked. I'm gonna go and carve the top. This is gonna be very messy. I'm really happy with how this has turned out. Spot on. And here we go. I mean, not traditional, but then again, when have we ever been traditional? So I'm going to glue the neck in. This neck, the neck, the neck of neckness. Let me just double check I put those in the right place. Phew. I made a guitar, mummy. I am so happy. I think these might be the shiniest frets I've ever made. I have been looking forward to this since I started this build. Nut blank. We've got a guitar to put together.